It's been 31 days since the accident at the WIPP facility near Carlsbad, New Mexico. To date, no official radiation readings have been disseminated to the public, nor has the risk of exposure been in any way adequately communicated to the general public. The word coming out of Officialdom is that there is no risk to human health, and the amounts of plutonium and americium and other radionuclides being released are safe. Yet the official spokesperson from the DOE for WIPP, Deb Gill, stated the site is just too hot to get anyone down there to take readings or conduct a physical inspection of any structural damage to the site or the radiological containment vessels, end quote. The fact is, there are no safe exposure levels to plutonium. It's 2 million times more poisonous than arsenic, and the ingestion or inhalation of 1/1,000,000th of a gram will, not may, but will cause cancer, according to Dr. Helen Caldicott. And one other thing, reports comparing plutonium, cesium, americium, strontium, as well as all the other nuclear contamination being released into the environment to bananas, riding in an airplane, or getting a dental x-ray are being put out there to mislead you and give you a false sense of security that everything is okay when it is not. Naturally occurring radiation from the sun or potassium in bananas is very different and, yes, harmless compared to ionizing radiation created by nuclear power plants and nuclear weapons. Naturally occurring radiation does not change your molecular structure upon exposure. Ionizing radiation does. Now, let's hear what the officials had to say and see actual plutonium, or I should say alpha, radiation measurements and cesium counts at the WIPP facility and other disconcerting factors involving this underground WIPP storage site.
Lily Negan.
Yes, I'm looking for Edwin Lyman.
Okay, well, this is Elliot Negan. I'm in the media department. Can you are you a journalist?
Yes.
What's your name, please?
DJ Welsh, Level 9 News, the internet news site.
DJ Welsh?
Welsh, W-E-L-S-H, and
okay.
I'm in Albuquerque.
Okay, what's in a, you're in a radio station, or what is it, internet?
Internet news.
What is the name of your news organization?
Level 9 News.
Level 9 News?
Right.
Okay, and what are you calling him about?
The WIPP site in Carlsbad, New Mexico.
Are they still having leaks there?
Hmm?
Wasn't there a leak there?
Yeah, there is, and from the reports coming out of that area, they're quite substantial, and I wanted to ask Mr. Lyman about the testing that they're doing, if you want to go in for a scan within 100 miles of the site. The DOE is going to perform these scans for free. And I also wanted to ask him a question regarding...
Scans of people who might be exposed? That
yes.
What he's talking about?
Yeah. There were reports of 32 trillion becquerels.
Okay, what's your deadline?
Today, by the end of the day, if possible.
What's your phone number? Okay, he's traveling right now. I will email him. He's checking email.
Okay.
I'll ask him to give you a call, okay?
And what was your name again?
My name is Elliot Negin, N-E-G-I-N.
Okay, Elliot. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Welcome.
Bye-bye.
I'll contact him right away.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you. Environment Department. This is Julie.
Hi, Julie. Is Mr. Flynn available?
You know what? He's on vacation this week.
He's on vacation. Is there anybody who's covering for him? Specifically the incident at Carlsbad.
You know what? I'll have to have somebody call you back. Butch, the deputy secretary.
Okay.
And I can have him call you right back.
All right. Appreciate that. Thank you.
Okay. Hold on just a moment. Let me get your number. Actually, let me have your name.
My name is DJ Welsh. I'm from Albuquerque, but I'm out of state right now, and I've been following the development of this incident in Carlsbad. Mm-hmm. And I have a couple of questions that I just wanted to ask him for clarification on.
You know what, I can connect you to Jim Winchester. Hold on just a moment.
And who is he?
Jim Winchester is our CIO, our CIO.
Okay. Would you leave a message for Butch also?
Sure.
Okay, appreciate that.
Let's see. 505-231-8800. And it's Jim Winchester. Do you want to call him or do you want me to transfer you over?
You can transfer me.
Okay, and if you get his voicemail, do you want to leave a message or do you want to try back?
I'll probably try back if I get his voicemail, but let me give you my contact number for Butch also, the deputy secretary.
Okay, go ahead.
It's
Hello? Hi, this is Jim.
Oh, hi, Jim. This is DJ Welsh. I was trying to get a hold of Ryan Flynn. I understand he's on vacation.
Yeah, he's out for this week.
Okay. I live in Albuquerque, and I'm out of town right now, and I've been following the developments of the incident at Carlsbad.
Yes.
Over the last week or so. And
yes.
I was wondering if you can comment on any reports of the DOE offering free scanning for residents within 100 miles of the Carlsbad area for radiation exposure.
I've not heard that, but what I can do is get you in contact with the DOE directly and see if that's the case.
The DOE is not being very forthcoming about providing any information at all. So that's why I figured I'd go to your office since you're state-related.
Sure. Well, I haven't heard, this is the first I've heard about anything about free scanning. So let me make a few calls, look into this, see what I can find out, and get back to you. Now, did you email us? Is that correct?
No, I didn't email you. I called. I got Ryan's number off a website.
Okay.
Your organization, New Mexico Environmental Department, and he was quoted in the L.A. Let me see.
Well, let me do this. Let me give you my email address, and then why don't you email me, because I'm on the road right now, but I can get back and figure this out a little bit this afternoon. So you can email me what your request is, which is basically what you just told me on the phone, one or two sentences. That's fine. And I can get that moving and then try to get back to you this afternoon.
Okay, I'd appreciate it. This seems to be a very dire concern regarding public health. I don't know why the DOE would be reluctant to, you know, give any information, only that, you know.
Well, they did hold a public meeting last night.
I am out of town, though. Yeah.
Yeah, no, I understand. I understand. But from the standpoint of all monitoring results, there's been nothing that's gone out that's been anywhere near threat to public health.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, the amounts that have gone out are typically less than what you would receive almost under normal circumstances. I mean, in other words, you take an airplane ride, you're going to get more radiation than you would based on exposure of what happened out there. You know, there's any number of comparisons that you can make. That's still not, you know, it's still not acceptable from our perspective as to what happened. And we are closely monitoring to make sure that, you know, the DOE is, numbers are matching what we're seeing, which they are. And they've got, you know, some issues they need to resolve with underground and contamination down there. Our concern is you know, foremost protecting public health. So from that perspective, we continue to monitor those sorts of things. We have had good conversations with DOE, and they are matching what we are finding in terms of radiation levels. So from that standpoint, you know, I think we're doing all right, knock on wood. But yeah, I mean, we're not pleased in general by the whole situation. Why don't you send me what you're looking for, and if there is a way that, and if there's some sort of capacity that what you're looking for can be done, hopefully we can, you know, deliver on that, or the DOE deliver on that.
Mm. Yeah, something that was very contradictory, a statement that came out from Deborah Gill, she's a WIPP spokesman for the DOE down there. She stated, yeah, and I quote, "There is no threat to human health or the environment." And then in the next sentence, quote, "We will not be able to get in there within the next couple of weeks because the site is just too hot." How does
What she's talking about, what she's talking about is getting into the underground mine,
mm-hmm,
where the contamination originated from. They don't know what the cause is yet. They think that it's potentially from one of the drums that potentially could have leaked. But they're not sending anybody underground right now until they figure out a complete strategy for going down there and safely accessing that. Now, between the underground and the outside atmosphere, there's 2,100 feet ventilation and many, many filters that basically block any and or most of the radiation that gets out there. The radiation that did get out there was the stuff that was able to get by filters, and it, again, it was very, very, very trace amounts, and that's just because it's impossible to completely filter out everything. What she's talking about, though, is for the folks who work at WIPP and for the folks that are going to investigate this and work on cleaning it up underground, they need to take every safety precaution possible.
Understood. What about the reports, though, that the ventilation system has been either shut down or collapsed, and the concern about the buildup of methane and hydrogen and other VOC gases in the panel area for the room where this accident occurred?
As the Environment Department, we've heard nothing that supports that whatsoever. I know there's a lot of rumors that are going on around there and in Carlsbad. Mm-hmm. That was kind of the reason why they had that. But we have not heard anything like that. Just time.
Okay. And so you can't confirm then or deny that there's been any collapse of the structure itself, because it's my understanding that these
they're pretty sure, like 99.9%, that there wasn't a collapse, because they have seismic monitors underground,
mm-hmm,
and they would have that activity up. I know that there was a couple articles out there that reference something like this. They are completely off base, okay, if that's kind of where you're getting your information from.
Well, what really happened at the WIPP? Whistleblowers and family members of the mine workers claim that the ceiling in one portion of the mine collapsed.
That there's been an incident and there's been a release of some radiation, but not to worry, just move along. Don't worry about it.
Oh, no, I understand that concern, absolutely. I think that the best coverage that I've seen right now is coming out from the Carlsbad Current Argus.
Yeah, I tried to get a hold of Zach. I did speak to him briefly, but he couldn't get off the phone fast enough, so I don't know if he had somebody in his office and he couldn't talk.
I think she struck a very good balance between, you know, addressing the concerns of a lot of people, which rightfully so, they should have concerns, and or reporting what information is available in terms of a threat level.
Mm-hmm.
I think he's been pretty level-headed and transparent with what the DOE has been saying and, you know, what we've been saying, what we're hearing as terms of what's going on. Frankly, they just don't know, because they can't get to the underground until they figure out the safest way to do that.
Mm-hmm.
They don't know the specifics of what happened underground. But in terms of a roof collapse, I think they've come pretty close to ruling that out. It's not to say that maybe a chunk fell and potentially might have hit one of these barrels. That's speculation. But either way, there was not like this full roof collapse based on what they're reading from the seismic activity, because there was none.
When looking to confirm or refute, the Secretary Flynn's spokesperson, Jim Winchester's statement that there was no seismic activity in the area on the date of the WIPP accident, therefore there was no structural failure to the facility, i.e. a roof collapse, I found this. The NMTSO suffered a catastrophic single point of failure on our system at 6:35 Mountain Standard Time on January 14th, 2014, exactly 1 month to the date the WIPP incident occurred. Goes on to say no seismic data has been recorded since then. This page will be uploaded when repairs are effective. And I think it's probably safe to assume that when and if this site does come up, there will be no archived seismic data for any events occurring on the dates from February 13th through the 15th at the Carlsbad site, which is located right in this area here.
But either way, there was not like this full roof collapse based on what they're reading from the seismic activity, because there was none.
There was none. Okay.
Yeah, there was no seismic activity whatsoever around the time that this monitor went off, an alarm, and they first got the reading.
Okay. So, all right, Jim, can you give me your email address? And what I'll do is I'll shoot you over some, you know, really brief questions. And
sure.
Hopefully you can provide some answers, you or Butch. Or...
Yeah, it's jim.winchester.
Winchester.
Mm-hmm. At state.nm.gov.
Dot gov?
Nope, it's at state.nm.us.
Okay. All right, I'll put that together in a few minutes. You should have it in about 15, 20 minutes.
Okay, appreciate the call. We'll get back to you.
Thanks, Jim. Bye-bye. You have a good day.
And here's the email I sent to Jim Winchester at the New Mexico Environmental Department. Jim, based on our conversation earlier, can you clarify and provide sources for the following being reported with regard to the above subject? Number one, private testing and U.S. DOE reports indicated the actual release of radiation into the air from the WIPP facility in Carlsbad was 14,400 times more than the initial estimates of 11,000 becquerels of combined plutonium-239 and americium-241 per cubic meter. Number two, it is being reported that the DOE has concerns regarding loss of control or integrity of the ventilation system at the site, which presents an elevated risk of fire and or explosion due to the concentrations of hydrogen, methane, and other VOC gases. Number three, Tuesday, February 8th, 2014, quote, a sample taken at a sensor 1/2 mile from the facility returned plutonium readings in excess of 1 million DPM per square centimeter, or roughly 1 gram per square meter, end quote. Question, would this not go to the fact that the airborne release would be much higher? Quote, a less probable cause was a radiological process inside a container that forced material out. Then I went on to say, it was my understanding that the air filters where samples are collected are above ground and do not require technicians to enter the 2,100-foot deep underground facility to collect their samples. Number four, why was the state and public health officials not informed immediately instead of several days after regarding an event that would have significant health and safety ramifications, even though the DOE and NRC officials claim radiation releases are at, quote, safe, unquote, levels. I think we can safely disregard these claims from the officials as we see how TEPCO and the Japanese government have criminally downplayed the Fukushima incident. Should not have this information been communicated to the public so they could have taken whatever precautions they deemed appropriate. Number six. The government is reaching out to residents and workers. CRMC, that's supposed to be a C there, is offering free body scans for the public within 100 miles of the release site. And last but not least, it is well documented that the nuclear industry is reputed to be the most highly regulated industry on the planet. Why then would two separate trucks traveling to the Carlsbad WIPP site south on I-25 back on January 7th, when I was returning from Fort Carson, Colorado, be recorded on a dash cam, transporting nuclear waste in the white dome transport containers and having the same ID number, container ID numbers, no differentiating, specifically container numbers 205 and container numbers 123, on two separate trucks? How is that accounted for upon delivery and destination for audit and accounting purposes? Jim, thank you for your time. Any additional information you can provide regarding the ongoing incident at the WIPP facility? The response was no response. So, the following day, on February 26th, "Hi Jim, just checking, haven't heard back from you regarding the email I sent you yesterday. Did you receive my list yesterday? To date, there has been no reply from the New Mexico Environmental Department." Well, it's Thursday, March 6th, and I'm on my way down to the WIPP site in Carlsbad. So I'll be getting back with you guys in about 3.5 hours. Just wanted to share with you some of the scenery and the views going down here to Carlsbad. I'm about 170, 180 miles in, with about another 170 miles to go. And this is pretty much the scenery and the terrain for the last 150 miles. So as you can see, these are vast, vast stretches of nothing for hundreds of miles, with the exception of an occasional ramp here and there. Just entering Carlsbad now, about, let me check.